Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
We thank God for the dawn of a new day and for a new beginning this week. As we continue to learn God's pathway to bounty and blessing and favor, particularly through this financial realm. And I pray that you will not tune off and say, oh, I'm going through so much. I'm telling you, beloved, you need to learn this. It doesn't matter the nature of the trial or problem. You will see that the power of God is released in this kingdom through a seed sown. But the seed must be prescribed by the Lord. If it's financial, he has to tell you the amount and where to sow it. So there is no way a man can be promised prosperity in this kingdom, and that man does not have a relationship with God. The man has to be able to hear from God. I will not produce surrogate children where I do all the hearing from God for them. No. I'll do that one or two times, and now I will insist that they go and fast and pray and return with a word. Hallelujah. And so we discovered a dimension we want to conclude on today, and that is this dimension of this righteousness that endures forever. We have studied in verse 9, as it is written, 2 Corinthians 9:9, he hath dispersed abroad, sowing bountifully, he hath given to the poor. That's a track record. Not just I go out and, like people do, like, you know, God is a slot machine, you drop in something, boom. No, he hath given to the poor. His righteousness remaineth forever. It's a lifestyle, it's a covenant relationship. And this righteousness in taking care of the poor and needy, the Bible says, will never be abrogated, will never. It is the will of God. It is the power of God in manifestation. Come on, beloved, look at this. The Bible says that we should not hesitate or shy away from entertaining strangers because some have entertained angels unawares. What does that tell you? These are all mysteries. It's showing you that in this arena of sowing and reaping and giving and helping the poor, you see, therein is the power and the force on the ability of the kingdom of God to rule over this natural realm. Angels traffic in this realm. The glory traffics in this realm. This is the realm of God's power and ability. As we learned 2 weeks ago, he's able to make all grace abound unto you. It's a realm of the superlative. We are in the bounty phase. The fruitfulness will double everything. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me take you to Psalm 112. Praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighted greatly in his commandments. Every time I read that, I say, Lord, I know I do your word, I love the scriptures, but delighting greatly in your commandments is something I desire. Some things you know that God is right, and man, I'm fascinated, like what I'm talking to you about. His seed shall be mighty upon the earth. You see, this is generational blessing that we bequeath to our children. We live in such a way with God that blessing is flowing down on them. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Look at this. Wealth and riches shall be in his house. Wealth and riches shall be in his house. That's not where most of the church is. We are, most of the church is in covetousness and lack, in strife and all of this. No. He said, a man that loves the Lord, a man that fears the Lord, a man that delights greatly in the commandments of the Lord, he said, wealth and riches shall be in your house. Your seed will be mighty upon the earth. And your righteousness will endure forever. He brings that thing again. What is this eternal righteousness the Bible keeps talking about? We'll find out. On to the upright, there ariseth light in the darkness. You see, because of this righteousness, light pops for you when things are dark. Deliverance comes. The way opens. Miracles happen. He is gracious, the Bible says, and full of compassion and righteous. A good man showeth favor and lendeth. He will guide his affairs with discretion. I'm trying to answer the question. That's why I'm reading along. Surely he shall not be moved forever. You notice? This eternal certainty. The righteous shall be in everlasting remembrance. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. Glory to God. So there's a few that claim to fear the Lord, and yet you're afraid about everything. Something wrong with that fear. Because when you fear the Lord, you fear nothing else. His fear brings you into a realm, into an intimacy. If there's fear in my life, I know there's sin present. Something's wrong. Fear is not of God. There's sin somewhere in my life. Listen carefully. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. His heart is established. He shall not be afraid until he see his desire upon his enemies. I didn't know that a man of God can have enemies, because there are people that are so avowed, it's like they are determined to bury my ministry and spreading lies and doing all kinds of things. I just laugh. They don't know what's coming. But look at verse 9. He hath dispersed. He hath given to the poor. His righteousness endureth forever. He answers the thing again. His righteousness endureth forever. That righteousness comes from taking care of the poor and needy as the Lord directs. I had a man whose ministry this is, and said this guy just comes and gets food, takes a shower, and then goes back out under the bridge. Wasn't interested in the gospel. And he was going to cut off his meals and all of that. The Lord said, no, you don't cut it off. And one day the guy just comes and gets saved. And now he's the preacher. He's actually the liaison. And thousands go to that ministry. It's an amazing thing when we can hear the Lord. That's how God will deliver you from fraudsters and people that take advantage. Sometimes we have people in our churches, they don't tithe, they don't give any money. They say they don't make enough money. And they'll come around one to get 1,000, 1,200, 2,000. That's crazy to me. But if the Lord says to give, we give. If he doesn't say to give, we don't give. Because you cannot sow into a land filled with concrete and pebbles, and you won't produce anything. Come on, beloved. Let's get with it. Hallelujah. It says, his righteousness endureth forever. His horn shall be exalted with honor. So if you want an eternal enduring righteousness, then sow into this realm. God will bless your life. You will experience greatness on the earth, and your children too. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.